Hey y'all, Zack here, the legal tech advisor at Lawyerist, and today I'd like to show you a little bit of what CosmoLex can do. Now, CosmoLex is a self-contained law practice management system with exceptional accounting capabilities, among other things. Now, today I'm not actually going to show you all of those accounting capabilities because they are pretty thorough, and if you're interested in those, I would suggest that you simply get a demo with CosmoLex. But today we're going to show you a little bit of those accounting capabilities and then look into the workflows and the client portal very quickly. So let's dive right in. So here we are in the account dashboard, and it's where you go when you log in, and you've got a good deal of information here that you can do firm-wide, you can do user-wide, and then you can also look at recent activities pretty quickly. But right now, we're going to go directly into accounting just to show you a little bit about this. And as you can see here, we already have a chart of accounts built into this system that are based on their legal law firm chart of accounts. This isn't something that you have to change very much if you, in fact, have to change at all. You have things like your client trust funds already created as a current liability, your advanced client costs as an other current asset, and things like that that are already set up because they know lawyers are going to be using these. And importantly, it is a full accounting system, so you have a journal of entries, you'll be able to keep track of your accounts payable, and obviously your accounts receivable. And then in the banking section, you can connect this account directly to your online bank account through a system called Plaid, where you can get the feed of your transactions downloaded directly into this system, so you won't have to do too much double steps of entering the transactions into your system again. This is much like QuickBooks or Xero or some other accounting systems, but it's certainly a nice to have and would certainly save you some time. So in addition to those accounting features, they also have some very special reporting that they do. Now you have the typical accounting reports like profit and loss, balance sheet, 1099 payee ledger, things like that. But this financial productivity section right here also allows you to break your finances into who created them. So you can tell what the billing was done by timekeeper, by matter owner, and then you can also do build fee allocation, which will allow you to do very easy billing splits. You know, if you have a 60-40 split with your associate, you'll be able to manage that right here. And that's not something that a lot of law practice management systems have, certainly not built in. So if you want to know more about these, I would suggest just contacting CosmoLex. This is a very, very robust accounting system, and I certainly can't get to all of it right now, but I'm sure they'd be happy to. But in addition to all of that, they also have these workflows that you can create based on, well, really based on whatever you want, but for the most part, based on the type of law, the type of matter that you've set up, that you've created. So here we have personal injury workflow and real estate workflow. You could use this add button right here to add as many as you want. But inside of these workflows are just a series of dependent tasks. And in this scenario, these tasks are all triggered based on how many days away from the workflow begin date they are. Now you can change these things. There are a lot of different types of triggers that you can explore when you get in here, but you can set up the person who's supposed to work on this task, how many days it's due after, let's say, the workflow begin date, obviously put a priority to it, and then you can add some description if you're not going to be the person that's actually doing this and it necessitates that. So you could add as many tasks as you wanted here. You could take these out, you can manipulate it, or you could create your own workflow as well. So we're gonna cancel out of here, and we'll show you that in order to use those, you just go to matters, open up a specific matter. We're gonna use Buster Keaton here. And then you go into tasks. Now over on the left-hand side are all the places that you can go inside of this matter. And in order to keep track of all of the things that you're doing. But right now we're just in tasks, and we're gonna go to add a task. Since we have a workflow that we wanna use on this for personal injury, we're gonna add the task using a workflow, but you could add individual tasks as well. So we're gonna add the tasks using the workflow. This is our begin date, and we're gonna hit create. Obviously we could grab any one of the workflows that we have right here in order to create it, but we're going to do personal injury. And then all 31 of the tasks were put into here. And so we've got them in the system. They all have a particular due date based on the amount of time that we gave them. And they're all assigned to a particular person where you can get to them in this tasks pane, or you could get to them on the dashboard or activities portion in order to see this. And so we'll actually show you in the activities for this user, me, we have all of these tasks, including some other tasks in here, but these are all the tasks that are coming up for this user. So we'll go back to that matter to show you the client portal, which is down here. And if you turn the client portal on, you can also determine what permissions, what portions of the file the client can see. And this is very important because it's actually very easy to see what you're limiting. And so we're going to take out notes. We're going to take out tasks. We're going to take out calendar events. And so all the client can see are invoices, messages, and then documents that we have created for them. And once we invite the contact in here, they will be in this portal and be able to share this information with us. And we will be able to securely communicate with them and securely transfer documents back and forth. So that is certainly not all that CosmoLex can do, but those are a couple of the more interesting features that they have right now. Hopefully this was informative. Hopefully you've learned something, and I will see you next time around the Lawyerist ecosystem.